Next up, we are going to talk about the Illinois governor's race. Attorney General Lisa Madigan announced around 5 o'clock yesterday that she's going to seek a fourth term as the state's chief lawyer. She is not going to run for governor. It has been much speculated about. Rick Pearson, why isn't she going to run for governor? Why is she going to seek a fourth term in a kind of mid-tier office?
Well, one real easy answer is the fact that it's her father, the House Speaker Michael Madigan. Arguably the most powerful politician in Illinois, the most powerful Democrat, and the inherent conflict. She cited a statement that was relatively new to a lot of us in saying that she was going to seek re-election. She said that she would never be interested in running for governor while her father held the speaker's post, and that it concentrated too much power in state government into one family. 4 years ago, when she also had been speculated upon as being a candidate for governor as well as U.S. Senator at that point, she opted to run for re-election, dismissed any talk about her father's position as Speaker, and instead said it was for family reasons. So I think what you've seen is there have been questions all along about potential conflicts, but in recent events, Mike Madigan and criticisms and questions about him have come to the fore, and if she were to run for governor, it wouldn't necessarily be a race so much about Lisa Madigan as it would be a referendum on her father.
What are the specific examples of why Speaker Madigan has been in the news? Metra?
Well, you've got the issue of Metra and the allegations of his trying to seek clout to help someone get a pay raise being cited as an example of, or a reason why Metra board members fearing that their contract budget funding for Metra was in jeopardy by the speaker, they terminate the guy running Metra and give him a $718,000 settlement. That's one issue, and that's still a very moving issue here as you've got various investigatory bodies going along.